Scientists say there are explanations for why people see ghosts. Can't they leave ghosts alone? Believing in ghosts doesn't hurt anyone, and in some cases it actually helps people. And also it's fun. But no, scientists can't resist endlessly telling us how wrong we are about why people see ghosts. If you're a believer in the paranormal and someone tells you that the place you're about to enter is haunted, you're more likely to have a paranormal experience when you walk into that place. That makes sense. It makes so much sense, in fact, that we don't really need a study to tell us it's true, but we got one anyway. In 1997, researchers put 22 people into a creepy theater and told them to make observations. Half of the subjects were told the theater was haunted, and the other half were told that it was under construction. Predictably, the half who thought they were visiting a haunted theater were more likely to report intense perceptual experiences. So those results seem to suggest that paranormal experiences happen mostly because people have been led to believe they might happen. In 2012, some researchers published a paper called Supernatural Agency: Individual Difference Predictors and Situational Correlates, which suggested that people who have paranormal experiences tend to be more open to the idea of spiritual experiences in general. It also found that people in threatening environments are prone to having non-religious paranormal experiences. In other words, instead of seeing an angel or talking to a god, a person experiencing environmental stress might see a shadow figure or a full-bodied apparition. That research has been backed up by other studies, including one that specifically looked at whether stress can cause women to report paranormal experiences. The study looked at a group of women in a town in central eastern Turkey and determined that women who suffered trauma in childhood or had post-traumatic stress disorder were more likely to say they'd experienced things like possession, precognition, and extrasensory perception. In 2006, a neurologist in Switzerland was attempting to isolate the part of the brain responsible for a 23-year-old woman's seizures when he blundered into a strange phenomenon. When he applied a current through a certain part of her brain, she told him she sensed a mysterious, shadowy person standing behind her. Even more creepy, the shadow person was mimicking her. Every time she moved, he would move. Some scholars think that researchers were simply stimulating the part of the brain that's responsible for that creepy feeling you sometimes get that you are being watched or followed by something that isn't there. But wait, there's more. Research using a device called the God Helmet, which sends magnetic signals to the wearer's head, showed that a person can be artificially induced to feel like there is a ghostly presence in the room. In other words, it's literally all in your head. You've almost certainly seen examples of this sort of proof of the paranormal. A photo of an otherwise innocuous person, place, or thing that contains eerie-looking balls of light, also known as spirit orbs. Similar manifestations can be seen on your favorite ghost hunting shows. The orbs that appear in photographs are usually just specks of dust or pollen, insects, moisture in the air, or something on the camera's lens. When the photographer engages the flash, these things reflect the light and create the image of a large, creepy-looking ball of ectoplasm. The phenomena is actually exacerbated by modern camera design. The closer the flash is to the camera's lens, the easier it will be for the light to reflect off particles in the air, and the more likely it is that the camera will capture something that can be mistaken for a ghost. Paranormal investigators often talk about cold spots, but haunted houses do tend to be old, and old buildings do tend to be drafty. However, according to party pooper scientists, cold spots are probably a natural phenomenon. When researchers actually try to find a reason for a temperature change, it can usually be traced to something like a chimney or a drafty window. The sensation of a sudden drop of temperature can also be related to a drop in humidity. Although it's also been suggested that paranormal experiences people have could have something to do with natural phenomena like magnetic fields and lightning levels. Either way, it's a lot less exciting than ghosts.
So, this place isn't haunted?
No, it rarely is.
Yeah, there's usually always some kind of rational explanation.
If you've ever fallen asleep in front of the TV, you may have experienced a phenomenon known as sleep paralysis. When you experience sleep paralysis, you'll be deep in REM dream state. But then you'll half awake and experience a sort of hybrid state of consciousness, where you're still experiencing dreamlike hallucinations. And just so the whole thing will be that much more terrifying, you also won't be able to move. Paralysis is actually necessary for safe REM sleep. It happens mostly so you won't punch your spouse in the face while acting out your fighting dreams. But when you experience it in a state of near wakefulness, it can be really scary. Add a few dream demons to the mix, and it can feel like a genuine paranormal experience. Sleep paralysis is actually common. About 8% of us will report experiencing it at least once, and for some people, it's a regular thing. But those feelings of a ghost at the end of the bed are just a feature of sleep paralysis. They aren't really paranormal visitations. Similar to sleep paralysis, exploding head syndrome is a condition that happens to you while you're sleeping. The experience usually goes like this. You're nodding off, and suddenly you could swear you just heard a massive explosion or a huge crash somewhere in your house. So what's the deal? Maybe you're hearing the paranormal echoes of something terrible that happened in the distant past, or maybe it's just exploding head syndrome. You may have actually experienced this phenomenon, but the name for it is still pretty new. It was coined by a neurologist named J.M.S. Pierce, who seems to think that it's caused by a sort of syncing error in the brain. As you're drifting off to sleep, your body starts shutting down things like muscles, eyes, and ears. When you suddenly hear a phantom bang during this process, it might be because the part of your brain that's in charge of shutting down all those functions gets a little mixed up. Instead of shutting down all the auditory neurons, it just fires them all at once instead. People who have lost close family members often report having paranormal experiences, especially in those early stages of grief. These could include vivid dreams of being visited by their deceased loved one, or feelings of being watched over, or even fleeting images of the person who died. According to the BBC, science thinks it can explain these experiences by calling them coping strategies of the grieving brain. The theory is that it's easier to accept the passing of a loved one if you think that person still exists in some form than it is to just believe that that person is gone forever. So the brain invents these spiritual encounters with the deceased person as a way of easing those feelings of grief.
Why would I want to see my Carl like that?
Because it's better than never seeing him again.
If your once peaceful house suddenly seems to be haunted, it might not necessarily be a ghost, and it might not be you either. In fact, it could potentially be something really lethal, like a malfunctioning furnace. So before you call an exorcist, make sure your carbon monoxide alarms are working, and if they're not, get out and don't return until your utility company says it's safe to. In the 1920s, the Journal of Ophthalmology documented the strange case of a couple who believed they were living in a haunted house. The woman reported hearing footsteps and the sound of someone pushing furniture around, even though there was no one else there. She also felt like she was being followed around the house, and at one point she woke up to see two apparitions at the foot of her bed. The couple spoke to doctors, but it wasn't until they had experts look at the house that they discovered the real cause of the haunting. A carbon monoxide leak in the furnace, which was bad enough to cause hallucinations, but not quite bad enough to cause death. So if you've ever wondered if ghosts can kill, yes they can. Or at least, the carbon monoxide that makes you hallucinate ghosts can certainly kill you. If you haven't changed the batteries in your CO alarm in a while, now would be a good time to do that. So your house is clearly haunted, you've already swapped out your CO alarm batteries, and then you tossed your CO alarm and got a new one, and ghosts are still throwing your stuff around and hoovering creepily in doorways. Well, it might still be poison-induced hallucinations, just a different kind of poison. Some researchers think there may be a link between the mold that tends to grow in dark, creepy places and the paranormal experiences people say they have in those places. This is of particular interest to Shane Rogers, who is a professor of civil and environmental engineering at Clarkson University. He cites a 2009 study which shows that certain types of mold can cause problems like delirium, movement disorders, and issues with balance and coordination. From there, it's not a huge leap to think that maybe mold could also cause the sorts of hallucinations that make people think they're seeing ghosts. So in 2015, Rogers and a team of researchers set out to find if their hunch might be correct. That's been a few years ago now, and we're still waiting patiently for the results of Rogers' research. If you're starting to think that some of these scientific explanations sound only slightly less outlandish than it's a spirit trapped on the corporeal plane, here's another theory that seems a bit out there. According to ProSoundWeb, ghosts could be low-frequency illusions caused by standing waves. In basic terms, it's when low-frequency sound creates a ghostly apparition. So, how does that happen exactly? Well, the author of the article had an experience involving a fencing sword and a fan. The fan was emitting a low-frequency sound that made the sword vibrate, and evidently was also making him feel like he was being watched. Even stranger, he also saw an apparition. Infrasound, which is the sound below the normal range that humans can hear, can cause physical and emotional sensations like feelings of dread. It isn't just fans that create infrasound, it's also things like ocean waves, vibrating pipes, and even some animals like whales and elephants. When the sound happens at just the right frequency, it can also make the eyes vibrate, which explains why some people who are experiencing infrasound believe they've literally seen a ghost.
I see dead people.
If you don't believe any of those other scientific explanations for the existence of ghosts, here's one that's pretty hard to deny. It's just fun to believe in ghosts. It's fun in the same way that a roller coaster or a horror movie is fun. We like to be scared, and because we're fundamentally attached to the idea that ghosts are real, it makes it hard for us to accept scientific logic. Belief in ghosts also serves another purpose. It helps us confront our own mortality. The presence of spirits in a house or an old hotel does more than just satisfy that sense of fun. It also helps us cling to the notion that there's something after death. A belief in ghosts makes us feel like we can glimpse an afterlife that we're all a little afraid might not actually exist. Even if you look at all these potential scientific explanations for ghostly experiences as a whole, they can't possibly explain away every single paranormal experience that's ever happened anywhere on Earth. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Grunge videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.